question. What kind of protection is that? The main protection is that.
This is better.
This covers everything but the places which need to be covered, at least from COVID perspective. We'll start?
Yeah.
Good evening. Today we have 100 new cases and 74 recoveries. This brings our active number of cases to 895. Samples received in the last 24 hours, 2,920. Samples tested, 1,850. And yesterday also, we tested around 2,250 odd samples. Suspects under hospital isolation are 24.
Hi, good evening. Even though now migrant movements has already taken place and most of the people have already gone, and there is no much change in the data, but still I'll share it. Possibly last time is that about 56,073 people have so far come in since 29th April 2020, and 1,57,431 people have gone out of the state. On action against spitting on public places, we have booked about 10,952 cases so far, and cases booked for non-wearing of mask are 35,682. Thank you.
There is a case reported in Kompurpa of a suicide of a boy. It is being claimed that he committed suicide because he didn't have a smartphone or online service.
First of all, I don't even know how to respond to something like this. But anyways, factually, the Director of Education has informed me in the morning that that boy actually had a smartphone to begin with. Secondly, if this can be a cause for suicide, then we have some serious introspection to do as to how our children are being brought up and how we are giving support to our children. That's all that I will comment on this. I don't think it has anything to do with anything regarding the working of Education Department.
Second question was the Patoda MLA yesterday said that there was some shortage of medicines and he was ready to pay for the medicines. I don't know which medicines he was referring to. There is no medicine for COVID treatment of Mr. Klapper's diet.
Absolutely not. We have got, all the COVID patients are equally important to us. Definitely it is unfortunate that the Honorable MLA is also one of our COVID positive patients, but equally for all of our COVID positive patients, especially those patients who are in critical condition, we don't want to leave any stone unturned. We want to ensure that our doctors have all the range of choices available before them, and so they can take a call as to what is the best course possible. You may be aware that there is this medicine called Remdesivir. It is being talked about a lot. There are differing opinions, of course, about its efficacy. But having said that, lots of hospitals across the country are trying it. So we did not want to leave that option unavailable in Goa. With the interventions, personal intervention of our Chief Secretary, sir, we got in touch with the company which manufactures it in Hyderabad. And within 24 hours, we ordered the immediate necessity. We are also placing a larger order with the authorized dealer. But directly from the company which manufactures it, we got our first 35 vials of that medicine just day before in the night. So these medicines are available. Remdesivir is one. All the other medicines which are possibly talked about in relation with COVID are all now available with our doctors. Plasma therapy, as you are aware, I need not again repeat. That option is also very actively being pushed forth with the leadership of the Dean GMC and his team of doctors there. The plasma bank has in a sense already started operation with our first donors giving their plasma. So there is definitely no shortage of medicines, and the lack of the medicine will definitely not be the reason for any problem.
What is his condition
of the Honorable MLA?
Yeah.
The report that I get from his treating doctor is that once he has been put on the non-invasive ventilator, NIV as we call it, his condition has definitely stabilized and his oxygen saturation levels are being maintained at a certain level. So that is the condition as well.
So he's still on ventilator?
NIV, non-invasive ventilator. He has not been intubated. He's not on the ventilator in the normal sense of the term that we understand it. It is a non-invasive ventilator. It is like a supportive oxygen supply.
How many patients are there on the ventilator?
there is only one patient who is on the intubation based ventilator. The others are all on the NIV as we speak.
Precautions or seriousness taken as far as Varna industrial estate is concerned, because number of COVID positives have been found in the areas and this has scattered everywhere now.
It is a matter of concern that we have had cases coming up in the Varna industrial estate, especially in the context of certain pharmaceutical companies. A couple of very strict measures have been taken. Number one, as you are aware, the Collector South has ordered the closure of certain of these facilities where cases have come up. Our Director of Food Drug Administration, Srimati Jyoti Sardesai, had a detailed meeting with the pharma company representatives just today in the morning, and she has reiterated that all necessary precautions in keeping with the guidelines of the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and MHA need to be followed.
In the past meetings that you have spoken about panchayat members and all would be given responsibility in panchayat area. I am talking about like an area like Kalamulu. It's like a very congested area where your house is very close, are scattered, and there were three COVID patients, positives which were coming, which were related to Varna. Now we 7 to almost 15 to 20 to close surrounding contacts are being checked. What about other things? Because it's really creating a danger. Why? Because these houses are so close to each other.
We are watching the Karambulam situation very closely. This was just the very first step, the first samples that you mentioned right now. Our health officers are seized of the matter. They are definitely taking every necessary step forward to see that they get a correct assessment of the area. So luckily today we got the results of quite a number of samples from there. They are all negative, but I'm not sure whether all results have come. But I got a set of results just before the VC began. Those are negative and those are from Kalambulu. So we are definitely watching the situation. We solicit the support of the panchayat, definitely. The proactive involvement of each and every panchayat all across Goa is very important. Every municipal council's contribution is very important to keep people alert, aware. One appeal, I'll use this opportunity to make an appeal to all the members of public. We have come out with an ad also. Has it come out today? Yes. So today in the newspapers, all of you may have seen the ad issued by the Director Health Service. Basically, we want people who are experiencing any symptom of fever, cough or breathlessness to come forward, get in touch with our PHC or at least call us on 104 number. So if you are experiencing symptoms, please don't wait for them to get aggravated. You know what the symptoms of COVID are. This advertisement was to create more awareness about the symptoms just in case somebody did not know. So please approach us. This is my fervent appeal to all members of public. Similarly to all panchayats, municipal bodies, if you can spread this message, media also, friends from media fraternity, please use every opportunity that you get. The police are also definitely making constant announcements in the containment areas, etc. Any symptoms of COVID, just please get in touch with us, nearest hospital, nearest public health centre or call us on 104.
Why I said it, there are two places like this. One is Kalambulam and there is another one called PDA Colony. There are almost units, 5,000 or 5,000 people staying there and so congested. So it's a really a concern. If your people...
Yes, we are keeping a watch on all such areas. But there's a logic to taking the samples and testing. We have to take it up progressively. First, I've mentioned and explained this before. We go in concentric circle. So we have to start with the focal area, the focal home where the positives have been found. Then from there, we have to expand. And then depending on how many more cases we are getting each day, we keep expanding. So if the first level itself throws up negative results, then definitely we get an assessment of what is the situation. We are on the job. Definitely our health teams are on the job.
How many COVID centers are there in Goa?
How many COVID centers are there in Goa? Let me just enumerate them for you. The first one was started at our PHC Shiroda. So that is the first one. Kolva Residency is there. Kalangut Residency is there. Kalangut Annex is also there. Then we have, I'm talking now of the SAI, Sports Authority of India Hostel in Pede. And Vindaji and Sanjay, please add on if I miss out any. In the south, we have COVID care centers. We have Fatorda Indoor Stadium. And I mentioned about Kolva earlier. MPT Hospital is one of our COVID care centers. And Madgaon Residency, we have kept it for the doctors, nurses, staff, government employees, etc. So that is also there.
How many patients are there?
In total in the COVID care centers? COVID. You see, we have 112 people in our ESI hospital. So the active cases minus that will give you the number of people who are there. One moment, I'll just quickly check on the, you may carry on, and as we speak, I'll check the figure once more about the ESI hospital, what is our latest data. Yes. That's right.
So what extra measures they have taken?
You see, immediately our health team has gone there and taken the samples of the people who are working in the same section as this person who was found positive. Today we have taken around 19 to 20 samples, to my knowledge, according to what the direct education told me. And then we are waiting for those results naturally. In the meanwhile, the office was shut and all measures are being taken to sanitize the area within the office, wiping it with the disinfectant and all of that. Those people working in the same section as this person have all been told to not come back to office even on Monday. They have been asked to stay at home and to maintain home quarantine. The number is correct. 112 is the bed occupancy of ESI Hospital. So active cases minus that, you will get the number. Yes.
The guidance for teachers for HRD and MHRD front, whereas teachers in Goa, they are coming in school. They are asked for to work from home. So any decision has taken now?
You see, we issued the circular in the last week of June asking the teachers to report to work in the schools. The secretary MHRD's letter has reached us just yesterday before, and it is dated the 6th of July. I want to set this straight because in one of the leading newspapers today, there is a news suggesting that we are flouting the MHRD's guidelines. That would be absolutely untrue because we issued our circular much before the letter of the secretary came to us. Now, immediately upon receipt of that letter, the Director of Education has put up the matter on file. And so, a decision will be taken by government. It's under submission.
MHA guideline was on 29th of June.
MHA never restricted, MHA never said that. MHA gave clear guidelines for the working of all workplaces. All workplaces. School is also a workplace. In school, what MHA had prohibited, you can read out the guideline. I've gone through it several times. It says that school should not operate for the teaching learning process. Students naturally cannot be called to the schools. Otherwise, the school is as good as any workplace. Of course, I am talking in relation to the MHA guideline, not in relation to the letter by the secretary MHRD. As I told you, that letter has just received, has been received by us, and we have put it up on file. But we have not flouted any guideline of MHA. I am 100% sure about that. MHA's guideline was only specifically about not having teaching process in schools. Yes, please read it out. Yes.
And online and distance learning shall continue to be permitted.
Yes.
And shall be encouraged.
Yes.
This is 29th June.
Absolutely. Yes. You see, for online education to happen, some teachers have to come. If you, every teacher does not have the facility to sit at home. Also,
Master Association says the teacher are taking that online teaching very well from home than school.
Well, you see, that teaching can happen from home also. There is no problem in that. But MHA doesn't say that teachers as a group of employees of the state should not be called for duty. That is a general instruction. We have to understand the spirit behind that instruction of not having the congregation of students in an education institution. And we have not asked students, we have definitely not permitted any school to ask students to come. But this is in relation to the MHA guidelines. As I am again reiterating to avoid any sort of confusion, our circular was issued on the 24th of June, if I'm not wrong, definitely last week of June, several days before the letter of the Secretary MHRD was received. Now that the Secretary MHRD has written that to the extent possible, the teachers have to work from, can be told to work from home and they should not be called to the schools, this has been put up by the Director of Education on the file. A decision will be taken by government.
Ma'am, does the Director of Education have any data pertaining to employees, as in the teachers, the teaching staff,
I wouldn't be sure if they have specific data, but in accordance with the guidelines issued by MHA for workplaces, where they said that certain categories of people can work from home. I think pregnant women was one category. Anybody above the age of 60, which is not very relevant in government service because of the retirement clauses. But all those things have definitely been reiterated in the circulars of the directorate. Whether they have specific data about comorbid conditions, I'll have to check with the director.
Madam, now Ganesh Chaturthi festival is approaching. Any specific guidelines will come for that? Because neighboring states, they have meeting collectors or health officials.
Yes.
They have issued feedback.
Okay, so this is something that I will not be able to comment upon right away, but definitely all the guidelines as are issued from time to time by the various ministries, the most important being the MHA, as well as the state government, will have to be abided by. Now, whether any fresh guidelines will be issued, definitely I will not comment on that right now, but we may have to, as you are rightly mentioning, we may have to take a look at this. Yeah, that's right. So we will have to deliberate on this, and definitely appropriate decision will be taken.
Ma'am, when the COVID hospital was established and you addressed us to the person, you gave us a breakdown of the number of ventilators, oxygen beds.
Yes. You see, the number of ventilators has definitely increased, because subsequent to those initial remarks that I made, we have got supplies of ventilators from Government of India as well as the supplier with whom we placed orders. So they are there, the ventilators are there.
Any numbers?
I wouldn't be in a position to give you the numbers right away, but definitely the number of ventilators has increased. And with regards to capacity of the COVID hospital, our total capacity is 220 beds. Oxygen beds are around 45 of them. Oxygen beds. And now, oxygen beds are different from the ICU beds.
Yeah.
Right? You are aware of that difference. So, that's the position.
ICU beds
would be? ICU, in the proper ICU that we have, we have 6 beds. But an ITU, intensive treatment unit, has also just been started yesterday on a completely different floor for the patients who are on NIV. On the non-invasive ventilator. So, Dr. Ira, who is the medical superintendent of South and also looking after the COVID hospital, has updated me today morning that since yesterday she has activated that ITU unit.
Okay. Also, is there any plan or proposal to acquire oximeters for the people who are, especially who are asymptomatic?
Definitely, yes. Our proposal is underway. In fact, we also have oximeters with us. In all the COVID care centers, we have provided pulse oximeters. No, each patient will not have one. In the COVID care centers, we have given the medical team sufficient number of pulse oximeters, and we have definitely moved a proposal to government to procure more of them.
Okay. About the 45-year-old from Vasco, has there been any investigation into the sudden death of the patient?
You see, yes, you see, he had fever for almost 6 days. You are aware of that. And he did not come forward. In fact, that is one reason why we came forward with this media campaign, because we were in fact shocked that a person from an area which is under the scanner, there are cases coming from there. Why would this person not come and approach the health authorities and say that he has a problem, he has been suffering from fever? By the time he came to our SDF Chikalim, he was heavily breathless. And so immediately he was his swab was taken, and then he was shifted for the adequate care to GMC. But unfortunately, we could not save him because it was too late by then. That is the reason why I have appealed again to members of the public that please don't take symptoms lightly. If you are having symptoms, then you should definitely come forward and inform us.
When is the antibody test starting?
You see, we have placed our orders, and the team from DHS is very actively following it up. So exactly when it is coming, I can only tell you that we are making all efforts to bring it to Goa at the earliest. We have already gone ahead and shortlisted who needs to be the... There are several suppliers, so we have taken the best rate and we have placed the orders. Hopefully, within a week, we should be having the antibody test. Same holds true for antigen tests also. We have placed the order for antigen tests as well.
So within a week, they'll start?
Hopefully. Within a week, we'll get them. First, we need to get the kits, then we can start off.
Ma'am, any update on the Kolwali jail?
Yes, Kolwali jail, you see, on the very first day after we received the information that one of the jailers is tested positive, we took 42 samples of the immediate, not exactly inmates, but the other jailers, the staff of Kolwali, plus two or three inmates who were in contact, 42. Those all are negative. Then we decided that every single inmate of Kolwali jail will be checked. So as a result of which, yesterday we took 161 samples. All of them are also negative. And today, as we speak, 226 samples were collected. And tomorrow, day after, they are going to collect more samples. Each and every inmate of Kolwali jail will be checked for COVID. So far, the news is good. We have not got any reported positive cases apart from that one jailer. All right?